Welcome back. For the first time in a long time, nag-start ang Ateneo Lady Eagles ng UAAP Women's Volleyball Tournament na may record na 0-2. Natalo sila sa parehong 5-set matches ng FEU at ng NU. Ano ba ang problema sa ngayon sa laro ng Lady Eagles at paano nila ito masosolusyonan? Kasama natin ngayon ang volleyball analyst si AJ Pareja. AJ, welcome back to the score.
Thank you. Good to see you.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, a lot of the Ateneo fans are not so happy mm-hmm. with this start. Pagka-intindi ko, it's been quite some time since nangyari itong start ng Ateneo sa women's volleyball na 0-2 sila, especially, for sure, not in the mm-hmm. tie-bundit era. Mm-hmm. But generally, sa napanood mo, they were both five-setters. And you know what, how we say about five-setters, these things can go either way. Mm-hmm. Pero so general observation mo, is it something for the Ateneo fans and the team itself to really kind of panic right now and say, this is not a good start?
Well, it's too early to tell. No, mm-hmm. I can understand where the Ateneo community is coming from. Mm-hmm. Na medyo worried sila because this is uncharted territory in mm-hmm. recent times.
Yep.
But it's still too early, and the two teams na nakalaban kagad ng Ateneo are powerhouses na may veterans
right.
na tapos na sa rebuilding stage.
Right.
But right now, Ateneo, since marami silang key losses, mm-hmm. they're now in the rebuilding stage.
Exactly. Okay.
But considering that they were up against FEU and NU in 2 5-setters, mm-hmm. commendable performance pa rin yan, considering na yung mga kalaban nila mas veterano sa kanila.
Right.
So at this point, still not time to be really worried about them.
All right. Well, you know, but given the attention to it, of course, and champion, they were in the finals mm-hmm. last year. They were the number one seed mm-hmm. coming mm-hmm. to the finals. You know, people are even trying to nitpick and try to look into this, mm-hmm. to what's happening. One of which, okay, you mentioned that they're in the rebuilding mode. It's a good point mm-hmm. to mention that they've got a lot of young players. Mm-hmm. Trying to fit in the shoes of the ones who have left, of course. Dina Wong is one, mm-hmm. the new setter. So mm-hmm. that's one thing. That the first game, the nerves got to her. Of course, it's one thing to practice mm-hmm. and play in the preseason. It's another thing when you're in the UAAP. Diba pagandong kala. So in that respect, first, let's look at the setting first and foremost. Is that a big concern for them, or you think she'll eventually get it with the skills that she's got?
Well, I do believe that she'll eventually get the hang of it. Because
okay.
based on observation, yung skill niya with Gia, of course, syempre, mm-hmm. raw talent pa rin siya compared
yeah.
kay Gia na talagang veteran.
Mm-hmm.
But yung speed ng bola, the distribution of ball, yung ball is actually pretty good. It's
mm-hmm.
just that, syempre, yung veteran experience lang, pag clutch situations,
yeah.
who will you give it to? Who,
right.
How will you distribute the ball?
Right.
Of course, that's one thing that she can learn as the tournament progresses mm-hmm. on. So, yeah.
She did say that she spoke to Gia before mm-hmm. the game. And interesting yung quote na yun, yung bit of advice sa Gia. Kasi ang sabi niya ni Dina, I want to be like you. Mm-hmm. I'm going to do my best to mm-hmm. be like you. Mm-hmm. Ang sabi ni Gia, don't try to be like mm-hmm. me. Just be the best mm-hmm. of who you can be.
Mm-hmm.
Is it good advice from a veteran who did so well and did so much in terms of a new player looking up to her?
Mm-hmm. Well, it's a really tremendous advice. Kasi
mm-hmm.
I'm sure that Dina really idolizes Gia.
Yeah,
but
sure.
yung mentality siguro ni Gia telling her to be you is don't limit yourself by just basing yourself on what I can do.
Mm-hmm.
Because bata ka pa, mas marami ka pang ma-achieve. You
right.
can still vary your own style.
Mm-hmm.
As long as it's pasok sa system ni Coach Tai
mm-hmm.
and as long as you can distribute the ball well, why not?
Right. Now, we look at the five setters. Interestingly, in the last set, of course, you know, for you to lose in those scores, may run yun, yung nanyara sa FEU, I think it was 59.
Mm-hmm.
But Ateneo was ahead 6-1 mm-hmm. in the fifth set.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it's rare to see a Coach Tai Bundit-led team lose their composure mm-hmm. late in a game like that.
Mm-hmm.
So, ano nanyara dun sa pagkalala mo? What kind of happened there in terms of how they lost their momentum there?
Well, actually, nung nag-switch sides
mm-hmm.
during the fifth set, talagang new momentum nasa Ateneo.
Yeah.
It just so happened na nagtuloy-tuloy yung passing errors nila.
Mm-hmm.
So it's one thing that has been observed in recent years, especially na nawala si Denden,
mm-hmm.
na yung passing proficiency ng Ateneo has nag-dip ng konti.
Mm-hmm.
So it's something that they should work on coming into this tournament, lalo na five sets, clutch situation, high pressure.
Yeah.
So that's where all the nerves try to come in, lalo na bata pa yung team.
Right.
So if they can develop, they can adjust, adapt to that situation, then I'm sure that they can regain their seed status from last season.
Right. Some of the fans as well, though, looking at the positive side, not looking at the overall outcome, but looking at certain moments, certain mm-hmm. sets, certain performances they did well. One of which was the surprise bullet ni Coach Tai of Gaston.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, she came in and she gave inspired performance. Talk
mm-hmm.
about her and how that could, you know, shed some insight on how this season will progress for Ateneo in terms of the rotation, in terms of Gaston being a part of it as well?
Well, based on preseason pa lang, marami nang usap-usapan na si Gaston is the new powerhouse na Ateneo. Talagang when it comes to power, talagang kaya niyang humampas ng malakas. Mm-hmm. And it just so happened na yung maganda yung pagkabunot sa kanya kasi para siyang spark plug eh.
Right.
Out of all the whole team, siya yung the one with the biggest personality.
Right, right,
so
right.
It's something that they can really benefit from, mm-hmm. lalo na pag napapasok si Pongay at tuloy-tuloy right. yung scoring niya.
I'll never forget when I first spotted her before when she used to just be on the bench. She was always dancing already. Yeah. Talagang personality, as you said, that kind of parang ano yun, it's not even worthy of describing her, the way she's just that ball of energy in a game. Okay, another interesting player who played well, although not the last 3 points, but to her credit, with the attention on her and the pressure on her and her family, Dani Ravenna, of course, coming in there as a libero. Talk about her and what it's like for her to come in for her first UAAP game.
Well, commendable performance from Dani. No? Given naman na their family of athletes, so yeah. athleticism is there.
Mm-hmm.
So it just needs more polishing when it comes to skill on how to read the ball, where the ball is coming from, especially coming from a serve.
Mm-hmm.
Na ang ano lang dyan, since bata siya, the challenge is how to be that person who will really command the floor defense of
right.
the court.
Yeah, exactly. So that was an issue, and you talked about this before I got in there, that was an issue even last season in yung reception nila, mm-hmm. and it was clear that they lost to NU with the aces towards mm-hmm. the end, and all three of those final aces went straight to Dani. Mm-hmm. Talk about that and how this is something that Ateneo has to continue to work on. Is it the matter of the pieces that they have, or is it a matter of, as some of the players said, we're still working on the chemistry. Mm-hmm. And doon naman kami lahat, we have what we need, pero yung chemistry na talaga hinayos pa namin.
Well, it's really just about yung getting the maturity mm-hmm. of the team. If you remember before nung Fab 5 pa, nung sila mm-hmm. Phil pa nun, nung mm-hmm. nagsistart pala na mag-libero si Den, then she's not the best of the liberos.
Mm, right.
Talagang yeah. nag-mature mm-hmm. lang siya
right.
with the role.
Right.
And towards the end of her collegiate career, siya na yung best libero.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's one thing that we should be expecting from the team, lalo na kung mag-focus sila sa pag-train right. kay Dani or kay Law as the libero.
Well, at the end of the day, with the incredible fan base they have right now as compared to those years when they were rebuilding then, iba yung demand for performance right away.
They're on a magnifying glass.
Yeah, na nga, exactly. So every little detail is really highlighted. So anong mensahe mo siguro sa mga fans out there, from the alumni to their fans, who are so eager to see them to stay at that particular level and maybe be in a bit of disbelief that, okay, we gotta accept some losses now kasi we're in rebuilding mode.
Yeah, kasi ganun naman talaga yung when it comes to history of UAAP. If you're top seed from last season, yung mga first few games mo coming into the first round, yun yung mga mabibigat na teams kaagad.
Mm-hmm.
And lalo na ngayon, yung mga teams na kalaban nila are done with their rebuilding stage.
Right.
So it's still too early to tell.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi the team can peak at the right time. Eh.
Yeah.
Ang laban na naman sa UAAP is, when will you peak?
Right.
So pag nag-peak ka towards the end of the first round na tapos madala mo na yun sa second round,
that's a good time.
Then that's a good
time. Exactly. And we've seen it happen time and again in both basketball and in volleyball as well. Okay, AJ, maraming salamat. We'll see you again soon. Thank you.
For more sports updates, keep watching The Score. And don't forget to subscribe.